be. But me, your man, Louis T. Welcome to the 2019 NFL Draft Prospects 101 series, your guide to some of the biggest and hottest names of the 2019 NFL Draft. We're talking edge rushers. And this next guy, really interesting what this guy is going to be at the next level and where he is selected. This whole offseason after the college football season has been a nightmare for Jalen Ferguson. First, he was denied entry into the combine. A simple battery charge stemming from a fight at a McDonald's as a freshman was enough to keep Jalen Ferguson out of the combine. However, it wasn't enough to keep QB safe as Ferguson racked up over 45 career sacks in his NCAA career, setting a record for most sacks by a Division I NCAA player while at Louisiana Tech, a number that was sure to get the attention of scouts, and that it did. So despite him not being at the combine, people were very anxious to see what this guy had at 6'5", 271 pounds. And so they showed up at his pro day, and it was bad. Really, really bad. He ran a 4.8 240. He had a 10-second split of 1.69. Hell, Quinnen Williams and company were in the 1.6 or 1.5 and some change. This guy's a 1.69, but the one that was the worst of them all was his 3-cone, which was an 8.08. I mean, it doesn't get much worse than that. Just to give you some proper perspective, you've got quarterbacks running in the sevens in the 3-cone, and if you're an elite athlete, you should be running in the low sevens, preferably in the sixes, all right, in the 3-cone. This guy ran in the eights, so it wasn't a great pro day, but the tape speaks volumes. The production is off the charts. You just got to kind of reconcile all of this in your brain when taking Jalen Ferguson into consideration. I think he's got something, man. I think he's got some juice off the edge. I think he's got the ability to get to the quarterback. There are some questions about his athleticism, and there are some questions about the kind of weight that this guy puts on. Is it all clean weight? There's some questions, obviously. And that pro day did not help his case. But when you watch the tape, there's something here to Jalen Ferguson, for sure. So 6'5", 271, four-year edge rusher out of La Tech, 51 games. As I mentioned, NCAA career high, 45 sacks, 66.5 career tackles for loss, 7 forced fumbles, 6 pass breakups, 2 block kicks. The guy did everything at La Tech. And so I think this is a guy that is very intriguing, to say the least. Now, how much of the pro day stock do you take into consideration? And how, if you're there, if you had people there in his body, how did it look? You know, this is a guy that couldn't come to the combine. He should have been in the best shape of his life. Was he not in the best shape of his life? I can't answer these questions. I wasn't at his combine. But these are questions that you take into consideration when talking Jalen Ferguson. Nonetheless, the tape doesn't lie. Let's get to some of that tape from 2018 because the guy is talented. There's no doubting that. We start on the road versus LSU and watch him keep contained on this play and then get a piece of the tackle. It's a really good job by Jalen Ferguson of coming down the line, keeping contained, and then getting a piece of the running back, Brosette. Here on this next play, latch and snatch. And explosive closing speed to pressure the quarterback, Joe Burrow, on this play. Watch him latch on and then snatch this quarterback and pull him forward and thrust himself towards Joe Burrow and explode towards him. You see that explosion? He got there in a hurry and was able to help force that incompletion. That should have been caught, though. That was a good ball. Bull rush to flush the quarterback out of the pocket here. And you'll see a lot of strength with Jalen Ferguson. He's a guy that does have a really good bull rush. Can get you off balance because you're looking for speed, and then he comes with the power. And so he does a really good job of translating speed into power. And you saw him flush Joe Burrow there on that play. Thought he was actually held on that play. I thought he was held on this play and the next play that you're about to see. I thought he was held on that bull rush as well, as you'll see him bull rush to tackle again. And if this isn't holding, I don't know what is. And if he can't get this call, I don't know what to tell him at the next level. But this is a hold right here. You know, that's a hold around the edge. But nonetheless, that's a good bull rush by Jalen Ferguson. Those two last bull rushes were quality rushes. that are winners at the next level. This is pure speed off the edge to produce the sack, force, fumble. Again, this tackle had his hands full with Jalen Ferguson on this day, and that's a good job of him not only beating that tackle around the edge with speed, but finishing it off with his hands and then getting the football out. And you know how I am about guys getting the football out. You saw him do it there. You'll get another look at it as Ferguson was able to win right off the snap with speed, finish it off with hands, and then turn the corner and get the football out of the hands of Joe Burrow. And that's what you're looking for from your edge rusher, is to not only win, but win big and finish it with an exclamation point if you can by getting a football. And Burrow was really sloppy there. Once you get hands laid on you in the pocket, you got to put it away. He didn't, and Ferguson got it out of there. Long arm of the law here to destroy the tackle and flush him out of the pocket. And again, you see Ferguson disrupting the play, forcing Joe Burrow out of the pocket and him throwing it away. So Ferguson, again, affecting the play here. He doesn't keep contained, and he allows the tackle to pancake him and gives the running back a clear, easy lane to the outside. Two guys get picked up and pancaked here. That can't happen. You and your teammate can't both get a pancake extra syrup on top. Right there, that's ridiculous, and that can't, and Ferguson's too physical at the point of attack for something like that to be taking place. Here against FAU, similar situation. He gets pinned to the outside, and he kind of runs underneath this block. You can't do that. You're the outside contained. You have to stay square there and make it tough for that back to figure out where he wants to go with the football. He made it so easy by going over top of that block and giving him a clear lane to run up there. Keeps contained here, a better job of that here. Tracks the back. On the backside, after initially missing, he comes back in, gets a piece of the running back, and gets him down on that play. Here, on this next play, he sets a nice, hard, physical edge. Now I need you to shed this block or shut the door, one or the other, but he does neither. That's a great job of setting a physical edge, but you got to get off that block, or you got to shut the door by reaching out your arm and getting a piece of Devin Singletary there. You can't let him run up that gap. That's a great job of setting the edge. Now make a play. He didn't. Here, little antsy, jumps off sides. Again, you'll see that with pass rushers from time to time, looking to get every advantage they can, including timing up the snap. He was unable to do that there and gives up a freebie. Here, too fast for the sifting player that's coming around. Look at him hesitate there and set up a situation where he's able to get by and force that quarterback to pretty much get rid of that football. And that's a great job of disrupting that play by Jalen Ferguson. Here, he sets a physical edge, then sheds for a tackle for loss. This is what I wanted to see on that last play. Set a physical edge. Now get off the block and make a play. He wasn't able to do it the last time. He does it here. I want to see more of that because he's fully capable of doing that in the run game. That's a beautiful play. Here, pure speed off the edge with hands to finish off the rush. And is that not holding? I mean, how is a flag not coming out of the pocket of the official who's standing right there? If that's not holding, again, I don't know what is. That's a beautiful rush there, though, by Jalen Ferguson. As we move on to the final game we'll take a look at in 2018 versus Mississippi State. This is great recognition of screen right here. He realizes, okay, you're trying to run a screen. He's able to then retrack his steps, turn and redirect and get to the outside and tackle that running back for a 2-yard loss. That's an excellent play there by Ferguson. Here, relentless effort to produce the sack. This is great second and third effort. He didn't win initially. He didn't win the second time, but he kept fighting. And Fitzgerald was there to be had, and he finally made the final move that allowed him to get to the quarterback. So that's a really good move there by Ferguson, staying with the play and ultimately doing what it took to get the quarterback down on the ground. And finally, his last play, awesome club move for the sack. Watch him get up the field, club, move that tackle out of the way, comes back inside. And there's nowhere for Nick Fitzgerald to go on this play. That's an excellent move by Ferguson. Watch him come up the field, get that tackle to open up, then give him the club and send him up the field and open up the gate to come down the hill and get to Nick Fitzgerald. That's an excellent rush there by Jalen Ferguson. I told you, this guy's got something to him. There's some juice here with Jalen Ferguson. Yes, the pro day was poor, but when you watch the tape, there's something here to Jalen Ferguson. I think this guy has a chance to do something at the next level. I'm anxious to see where he goes. I think the poor pro day is going to drop him out of the first round. There may be some team that comes calling late first round. If there's a run on edge rushers and someone feels the need to go get their guy in the first round, maybe he still ends up being a first round pick. But that pro day, I think, might have cost him a first round selection. And so I think he's going to be a day two guy, but he's coming off the board in the second round. He can get to the quarterback. And I think I look at him, a great comp for him to me is Lamar Woodley, ex-Pittsburgh Steeler and Oakland Raider. This guy looks a lot like Woodley. Woodley wasn't as tall, but similar stature, that thick, full, and solid frame and physical in the run game, but can get up the field. Wasn't the most explosive guy was Lamar Woodley, but he could get up the field and get to the quarterback. And I think Jalen Ferguson can do much of the same. So that's my comp for Jalen Ferguson. And I think this guy has a chance to make an impact at the next level. We will see. But I'm your man, Louis T, signing off. Remember, if it's not your man, T, it's not the best NFL coverage it could be. Make sure you subscribe to the Louis T Network if you haven't already done so. Also, check out the Louis T Network podcast, available on Apple Podcasts, available on Google Music Play, available on Stitcher. Tune in, and of course, Spotify and the website, LouisTNetwork.net. Join me, your man, Louis T, for the 2019 NFL Draft Party as we'll be watching the first 2 days of the draft live and breaking down each and every single pick as they happen in real time and taking your analysis and your input in as well. We'll be chopping it up, having a really good time, breaking down these picks, talking about the fits of these players, and talking about where we think some of these players will go and all of the things that go and come into a draft here on the Louis T Network. Draft Party alive Thursday and Fridays, days one and two of the 2019 NFL Draft. I'm signing off. I'm out of here. You guys have a good one. Take care. Louis T Network.